Hello, my name is Brian Campbell. I'm the Director of the Bureau of Curriculum, Assessment, and Instruction in the Office of Elementary and Secondary Education at PDE. Today's presentation is another step in our continuing effort to support school communities in outlining the limitations inherent in interpreting the 2020-21 assessment data results. PDE extended the 2020-21 assessment window through the fall of 21 to maximize schools' ability to safely administer the federally mandated assessments. The extension of the window delayed final data reporting accordingly. However, the U.S. Department of Education did not waive the testing requirements. Students were expected to participate. Nevertheless, participation in the 2021 state assessments decreased 27% from 2018-19, the last regular administration of the state assessments. Pandemic-related disruptions impacted testing conditions to varying degrees across the schools and regions. While the decreases remain fairly consistent statewide, the data shows that schools and specific student groups were disproportionately affected throughout the pandemic. Students impacted do not necessarily represent a relative sample of the state's population. Low participation yields results that are not representative of whole school or whole student group performance. An added layer of analysis is necessary when reviewing participation in the Keystone exams. Remember that exams were waived in school year 19-20. Keystone exam results are banked to grade 11. The displayed data is not representative of the number of kids who tested last year. Results are reported using the current 11th grade cohort's best score to date. Act 136 of 2020 waived banked scores for middle and high school students who would have taken a Keystone exam in school year 19-20, decreasing the count of eligible testers in the cohort of test takers in 2021. Thus, students who successfully completed trigger courses in the year of the canceled tests are omitted from the accountability calculations in their 11th grade year, not in the year in which they test. The combination of Act 136 waivers and lower overall participation in general contributed to a 52% drop in the number of reportable Keystone exams across the content areas. However, the drop was very inconsistent across the subjects. The drop is most likely tied to the year in which the exam is given in school. We know that the literature course and exam are almost universally given in 10th grade. Because current 11th graders were 10th graders in 1920 and received the waiver, only 9% of the reportable students have banked 11th grade scores. Biology is a course that is split fairly evenly between 10th grade and 9th grade. Thus, there are about 48% of the reportable students who have banked scores for 2021. The remaining have a waiver that will eventually be reported in their 11th grade year. Algebra 1 is split between many grades, including middle school grades in many schools. Thus, 85% of the students had reportable results as 11th graders in 2021. The extremely low number of reportable literature scores makes it appear that performance dropped by 22% since 2019. That is very unlikely to be true. Not only is the number reduced greatly, the representativeness of that sample is also different. Here you see the 2021 English Language Arts PSSA results. You may notice a drop in proficiency from about 3.5% to 7% across the grade levels. More importantly, you should notice a drop in participation from about 25% to 31%. This means anywhere from a quarter to a third less students participated in the exams this year. You'll notice similar trends in the math and science PSSA scores. Math proficiency decreased from about 7% to 11%. Science proficiency decreased from about 2% to 7.5%. Participation across the exams was consistent with ELA, decreasing from about 24% to 31%. In addition to the drop in the overall number of testers, modes of instructional delivery, student attendance and participation, school staffing, pupil transportation, and other testing conditions were impacted by the pandemic and pandemic mitigation efforts to varying degrees. Also, to issue the exam in the safest possible environment, schools were encouraged to use various points of the extended administration window, varying the amount of time between the conclusion of direct instruction and the administration of the exam for many students. All of these factors result in an incomplete data set that has little or no comparability across schools in different regions or with data from previous years. The impact of irregular participation in the Act 136 waivers is perhaps best demonstrated by reviewing the 2021 Keystone exam results. Performance on the literature Keystone dropped 22%. However, that score is reflective of only 9% of the eligible testers. Most students received a waiver as 10th graders in 1920 and are therefore exempted from the calculation. The score is most certainly a reflection of the participation, not of student performance. The Algebra 1 scores remained essentially flat. You'll also notice Algebra 1 reflects the smallest decrease in participation, with about 85% of the eligible testers reported. While that didn't significantly affect this year's results, those students who took the course in grades 7 through 9 will be omitted from the results in future years. Biology scores increased by 4.5%. However, only about half of the eligible testers are reflected in the count. How the waivers affected the relative sampling won't be fully evident until the remaining cohort are excluded next year. These changes in scores are clearly more correlated to participation than to performance. As we've described throughout this presentation, we expect to see continued effects from the banked 2019-20 Act 136 waivers. It's anticipated that 40% of the 11th grade Algebra 1 cohorts will have a waiver in school years 2021-22 and 22-23. Those students will be exempted from those reporting calculations. It's also anticipated that 50% of the 11th grade biology cohort will have a waiver in school year 21-22. Again, those students will be exempted from the calculation that year. In any year, multiple data points, such as participation and attendance rates, academic growth data, and local assessment data, should be considered simultaneously when analyzing student performance. Given the differential effects of the pandemic, comparisons between schools, across districts, or across school years cannot be made with the 2021 assessment data. While the data limitations prevent cross-year comparisons and comparisons between school entities that tested in different times under different conditions, results may be more useful for evaluating the academic impacts within a given school or school entity. Within an LEA that is confident students tested in similar conditions in the same period of the testing window, These scores are appropriate for selecting, planning, and implementing tiered academic supports. In addition, these results may provide parents and families of students who did participate in the testing some evidence of how their student performed. It's important to remember that, in accordance with Act 136, the 2021 state assessment results are not used in educator evaluation. Pennsylvania's forward-facing tool for reporting and analyzing the data continues to be the Future Ready PA Index. Before the pandemic, the Future Ready Index was updated each fall using the most recent accountability data for any given school year. Since the onset of the pandemic, the index has been updated in waves as the information becomes available. The indicators listed on the slide here were updated on March 4th, 2022, with the release of the 2021 assessment data. The academic growth data for school year 2021 will be available in mid-April and posted in May of 2022. We plan to release the entire 21-22 school year data set in the fall of 22 and resume our annual pre-pandemic release cycle. It's important to remember that there is no waiver for participation in school year 21-22. Students are expected to test as the pandemic effects normalize, and schools not reaching 95% participation will be subject to adjusted proficiency scores. Last year's extended testing window, federal and state testing flexibilities through waivers, and the irregular, historically low test participation rates have impacted the availability and comparability of certain data elements. As a result, users may notice some modifications to the Future Ready Index display and functionality. Some of these changes were necessitated by the lack of complete data sets. Others have been made in an attempt to assist viewers in accurately analyzing the data. One of these changes is the arrow-shaped icon that compares a school's increased or decreased performance in the same indicator to the previous school year. The indicators listed on the slide do not have full sets of previous year data for a comparison. Therefore, the arrow-shaped icon cannot be displayed. A new data sampling error message has also been created. Because of the waivers, extended window, and irregular participation, a new designation, insufficient testers, has been developed to maintain reliability and protect student confidentiality in schools with more than 20 eligible testers in which less than 11 participated. Also, due to a lack of available data and decreased comparability, the following changes will be made. We will not display a 2030 goal for assessment-related indicators. It's not appropriate to benchmark progress from the last available data set, 2018-19, which is pre-pandemic test results. Without the goal, we cannot color code assessment and other listed indicators. The color coding is a result of a measurement of progress toward or against the 2030 goal that is no longer in effect. Also, the compare schools functionality will be paused until the growth data is released in May and a full data set exists for each LEA with which to compare. If you log on to the site, we will offer guidance in pop-up text boxes that appear throughout our help menus and landing screens, and also in user guide documents available to you in the footer and glossary of the website. A technical appendix and manual are also available, as are the data sets themselves in the footer of the web page. If you'd like even more information about the reporting and analysis of scores, please visit PDE's website at the address you see on the screen. If you've got questions or concerns, you can contact PDE's Division of Assessment and Accountability. Thank you for your time and attention and your dedication to education across the Commonwealth.